The kidneys filter blood to excrete waste as urine and maintain appropriate solute and water concentrations throughout the body. They do this broadly by filtering blood and then reabsorbing lost nutrients from the filtrate back into blood. The kidneys also have several other roles to maintain homeostasis in the body. In this video, we'll give you a visual mnemonic to help you remember the high-level functions of the kidney. First, take a look at this can of kidney beans we're pouring into our food strainer. These kidney beans are our symbol for the kidney organ. Get it? Since kidney beans are shaped like kidneys, and they even have the word kidney in their name. So, kidney beans to anchor us to the kidneys. Let's move on. Next, notice the metal strainer we're using to rinse these kidney beans. You never know what might be in these canned goods, so it's a good idea to give them a thorough rinse to filter out any junk before eating them. This strainer filtering the beans should remind you that one of the main mechanisms of the kidneys is to filter out waste, just like how this strainer filters out any junk from our food. Now take a look at that big sponge sitting on the sink. You can see it's doing a good job at soaking up all that filtered dirt and water. This sponge reabsorbing the liquid filtered by our strainer is our recurring symbol for reabsorption, the other main mechanism of the kidneys. You know, an absorptive sponge for kidney reabsorption? To understand why this happens, know this. The kidneys function by filtering almost everything out indiscriminately, then selectively taking back what it wants by reabsorption. Okay, let's now look at that kitchen drain all the rinsed off water and dirt is moving into. This image of the filtered waste moving down the drain represents waste removal by the kidney, because waste is removed by going down a drain, get it? As you probably know, waste removed by the kidney takes the form of urine, which contains phosphate and nitrogenous waste products like urea, uric acid, and ammonia. The nitrogen for these products comes from the metabolic breakdown of proteins, which produce nitrogenous byproducts. The reason animals have kidneys is to provide a way to eliminate these nitrogenous byproducts. Therefore, the goal of the kidney is incomplete reabsorption of these nitrogenous wastes. So you may be wondering why we're even rinsing our kidney beans in the first place. Well, it's to make soup, of course. Take a look at that measuring cup our cooking partner is using to pour water into the pressure cooker. This pressure cooker is where our kidney beans will go as soon as we're done washing them. Here, the measuring cup and pressure cooker should help you remember blood volume and pressure regulation. Get it? Since measuring cups work by controlling volume, while pressure cookers work by controlling pressure. Just like our partner, carefully pouring only the required amount of water into our cooker, the kidneys tightly regulate blood volume by controlling the amount of solutes reabsorbed by the body. Reabsorption of sodium ions is tightly coupled to water and chloride ion reabsorption, so that the more sodium ions get absorbed, the more water volume we have. Hormones like aldosterone can regulate sodium reabsorption, and the arteries leading into and out of the kidney can also be contracted or dilated to control the amount of blood volume. We have separate videos dedicated to these details, but for now, just remember that blood volume and pressure are maintained by the kidney. Let's now shift our attention to the contents of our cooker. Looks pretty strong, doesn't it? No one likes oversalted soup, which is why our partner is making sure to dilute it with water from the measuring cup. Let this diluted soup remind you that the kidney controls blood osmolality, or concentration, by reabsorbing water. Specifically, antidiuretic hormone, or ADH, is especially important here. Later, you should check out our dedicated video for ADH to learn more. For now, just know that your kidneys control the reabsorption of water to dilute your blood. Make sense? Let's keep going. Next, notice the slices of lemon that are also in the pressure cooker. When it comes to acidic food, nothing beats lemons, right? Lemons are Pixorize's recurring symbol for acid, which should help you remember that the kidneys play a crucial role in maintaining acid-base balance. Lemons for acid, get it? The kidneys maintain acid levels by reabsorbing bicarbonate ions and secreting protons, thereby keeping blood pH at healthy levels. Now that we've covered the major functions of the kidney, let's talk next about the spatial organization of the kidney structure. We'll use this pressure cooker as a framework for discussing this. Note how the middle, or inside, of this pressure cooker contains our salty soup. Let this salty bean soup sitting inside the middle of the cooker, remind you that the inside of the kidney, or the medulla, is saltier than the outer portions. This salty soup wouldn't be on the outside of the cooker, right? It's gotta be in the middle. This salty inner portion of the kidney is known as the medulla. And the high salt content of the medulla plays an important role in reabsorption, which we'll talk about in our dedicated video on the loop of Henle and the nephron. Last but not least, pay attention to those electronic controls on the outside of the cooker. Where else would the controls be? I mean, you wouldn't expect these controls to be on the inside, right? By the way, these controls should remind you of the cortex, and they are outside the cooker to remind you that the cortex is the outer portion of the kidney. A lot of students get this vocabulary confused, so just remember this picture. Cortex on the outside, medulla on the inside. Got that? All right, that's it for our overview on the kidney. Let's summarize so we can get on to eating this soup. The kidneys consist of an inner, salty medulla and an outer cortex, and uses mechanisms of filtration and reabsorption. They function by filtering out almost all substances indiscriminately, and then selecting for specific things to reabsorb, like water, salts, and nutrients. Anything that is not reabsorbed is ultimately excreted as waste products in the urine. To maintain body homeostasis, the kidneys also play important roles in controlling blood volume, pressure, and osmolality, while also maintaining a proper acid-base balance. Okay, now we're ready to tackle the nitty-gritty of how this organ works. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. For more videos like this one, subscribe to our channel and check out our newest lessons. For more resources on this topic, including fact lists and interactive review images, click the image next to the More Here arrow. I'll see you next time.